Hi, I'm Rachel Stravelli. I'm a writer, coach, and speaker. And today I'm talking about my own manifesto, why I do what I do. And I'm excited that you're here. First off, go ahead and give a thumbs up to this video. Like this video, click the button below to subscribe, and that way you'll never miss a video. And I look forward to connecting with you over all of these videos that I'm creating. I am so excited to talk to you today about why I do what I do and what my personal manifesto is about this, and hopefully this will inspire you to create your own manifesto too. So I have had a few different careers in my life. I've been a public school teacher. I've worked as a research assistant at a university in Vancouver. And I have worked for nonprofits. I've done a lot of environmental education. I'm a really big protector, preserver, conservationist about the environment. And I value nature and the environment so much. And in the past few years, I was a garden coach. So I taught people how to start and maintain organic gardens, how to plant edible landscaping, and I still give a few talks about that here and there. But what happened was my soul's calling encouraged me over the past few years to go broader and go bigger. And so even though I loved working with people, teaching them how to grow a garden, I was constantly, every time I took out my journal and was looking around at the signs in my life, the signs showing up, I kept on being told that I needed to move on and do more like a spiritual type path in my career. And finally, I got to the point where I couldn't deny it anymore. And so that's why I'm creating these videos. That's why I have my website, soulpioneer.com. And that's why I work speaking, writing, and coaching with people. Because I have a couple core beliefs. One is that we are all creative and we are all divine. I think we all have something of the divine in us, and it's what makes us amazing. That also means we're all connected then. If we're all divine, then we're all connected to divinity and every other person. And I think we're also connected to nature. You know, we were born on this earth. We are a part of the earth, and it is a part of us. And our connection to nature is paramount in what we do. Our connection to our inner selves, to this divinity within ourselves, is paramount. And I think we must connect to the whole of who we are to feel good, to feel fulfilled, to feel like we can make an impact, and to honor our world and honor each other. When we spend the effort to connect to our core and to connect to ourselves, you can start to get so much energy happening in your life and so much motivation. That's how I have so much motivation to do this, even though I have a 7-month-old baby. And some nights I'm not getting that much sleep. But I can't stop the writing that comes out of me and the words that I want to speak and the connections that I want to make with you, because I feel so driven to do it. Because I'm so connected to my inner wisdom, to my intuition, which is speaking forth and telling me to go out and connect with you. And I think you connecting with your inner self is going to have such a powerful, amazing impact on your life. It's going to move you forward. And sometimes people are nervous to connect to something inside of them because they think it's going to be scary. It's going to be dark. I don't know what's going to happen. What if I listen to my inner voice and it tells me to do all these crazy things? But the thing is, I have a couple things to say about this. You don't have to do anything your inner voice tells you to do. My inner voice was asking me to stop doing garden coaching for a number of years, and I didn't follow it. I kept on doing what I was doing. Sometimes, and I work with my clients on this too, it's actually interesting to notice what happens when you don't follow it, because sometimes it makes you realize even more like, oh, there is so much inner wisdom inside of me. And when I don't follow it, these are the things that I see that happen. And it just reinforces even more my belief and my connection to myself that, yes, I want to follow this wisdom that's coming up, even if it's irrational, even if it seems illogical, and even if it makes me a little bit uncomfortable. you know, we like being comfortable, but I don't think being comfortable is the point of our lives. Like, you may want to get to a place of financial comfort, but in terms of feeling comfortable in yourself and in the things that you do, I don't think that that should be the criteria by which you determine, should I do these things or not? Because a lot of the things that you want to do and perhaps dreams that you have and goals that you have, they're outside of where you are right now, which means they're outside of what you're comfortable doing. All right, so again, I'm so glad that you tuned in. If you want to click below, I have a link where you can connect to me. You can download my Reclaim Your Life guide. It's a really great way to get started on tapping into and tuning into your inner wisdom and connecting to what really matters to you. And it's also a great way to start thinking about, what would my manifesto be if I was going to write one? I shared with you my words, but you have your own manifesto as well. You have the things that are your deep core beliefs that drive you forward. And sometimes it feels great just to put those on paper, put them up on your mirror, put them on your steering wheel, put them somewhere where you're going to see them on a regular basis. And it really helps you to reset in this world where there's so much stimulation and information overwhelm coming in all over the place. If you know what you stand for and you know what are your core values, no matter what, it's really so much easier to say no to things that don't matter to you, to stay focused on what you want, and to gain energy from valuing the things that you truly value, that feel so a part of the core inside of you. All right, once again, I'm Rachel, and give a thumbs up to this video. And if you want to click the link below to get my Reclaim Your Life guide, it'll help you get started on this journey of connecting to your inner wisdom. And I'm so glad we connected today. See you soon. Bye.